Each of us have our triggers, which triggers in us an emotional reaction. Now these emotions are energy in motion, and this energy must be released. Hi, Namaste. My name is Kartika Nair, and you're watching Synchro Shakti. Welcome to the 10 powerful ways to release your emotional energy. First, cry it out. Crying is a physiologically designed mechanism for you to release emotional energy. Second, write it out. Writing is an expression of this emotional energy. Third, in the shower, use the prana energy in the water to cleanse yourself of the emotional energy, which means when you're under the shower, just put the intention that this water is releasing this emotional energy from your body. This is why a lot of people feel much better after a shower. Fourth one is what I call ha breathing, which means it's a breathing that sounds like this. This releases a lot of tension and pain. Fifth one is sublimation, or channeling this emotional energy into something else, like singing, playing music, art, or creating something. Sixth one is movement, exercise, or dance. Every time your body is in motion, the energy is also in motion, which it's like when you see the ducks, when they fight, they flap their wings. It's for them to get rid of that excess energy. So movement allows the energy to dissipate. Seventh one is catharsis, getting it out on something else, not someone else, something else. And I would suggest banging on a pillow. Second is screaming into an empty room, whichever works, is getting out the energy. Ninth one is releasing resistance to what happened. So whatever happened that caused you to feel a certain way, look for the gift in that experience. Learn to see that this was actually a good thing, that this helped you, and so you release resistance and you no longer feel threatened or upset by that. And the tenth one is to embrace your emotions, to embrace however you feel in that moment. The idea of embracing it instead of fighting it or resisting it allows the energy to dissipate and heal. Now, mastering your emotional self is something that takes practice, and it's something that you want to incorporate into your life in general. If you would like to learn cool tools and techniques like these, like the ones that I share in my videos, you can join in on my online coaching program. But also, if you are living in India, I'm hosting a one-day workshop in Bangalore City on the 8th of November, where I teach and give to you guys the most effective, powerful tools to master your mind, your emotions, the present moment, and your spiritual aspect for you to balance them all out and master yourself. If this is something that does interest you, there are links in the description box to where you can register, how you can find out more, and how you can contact me. And I hope to see some of you there. And for everyone else, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you again soon for another video. Thank you. Have a nice day. Namaste.